Hey guys, in this video I'm going to configure OSPF as the IGP inside AS30, and you have the requirements in the PowerPoint presentation. All routers should run OSPF process 1. We should only have point-to-point links. Loopback interfaces should be passive, and we're going to configure groups in order to achieve this. And I'm also going to configure MPLS-TE because we're going to need it later, and I'll just put the configuration under the group also. So if you never worked with groups, you can put some configuration under the group and then apply under different parts of configuration. I'll just show you and you'll pretty much understand it without any further explanation. So here I could have put point and star, and I would have matched any OSPF processes, but I just want to apply this group configuration for process number 1. And here I'm going to apply the configuration. It's MPLS traffic engineering, router ID, loopback 1. This is under the OSPF process, but then I also have some more specific configuration under the area. So I'll just go ahead under area 0, and here I'm going to enable MPLS-TE, and then under interface loopback, and by loopback I mean anything that starts with LO, I'm going to make them passive interfaces, and then under anything that starts with gig, like this. So this is regex, and anything that starts with gig will inherit this configuration, and I want all my gig interfaces to be configured as point-to-point. And then you just do an end group and you exit the group configuration. And by the way, this is how it looks. Then we're going to apply this group configuration under the router OSPF process. So under router OSPF 1, apply group OSPF, and then under area 0 I need to enable all these interfaces that I want to activate under the OSPF process. So it's loopback 1, I'm on R31, and I also have 4 more physical interfaces: gig 003, 0, 4, 5, and 7. So this is the configuration I'm going to apply. Let's just copy this because we're going to apply on all nodes. And if we check the router OSPF configuration, you see these together with whatever the group brings. And in order to actually see the whole configuration that gets applied on the router, you need to also put an inheritance in the end, and this is the actual configuration that gets applied on the device. And now, of course, I'm going to need to apply all these on all my nodes, so I've done it with 31, and the next is going to be 32. So the group will be the same, I just need to change the interfaces. So for 32 it's 3, 4, 5 and 8. So a bit smaller, and this should work. Then for 33 we only have 2 interfaces, 2 and 1. For 34 again only 2 interfaces. And it's the same config. 35 the same. 36 is going to have 7 and 8. So it's 7 and 8. Okay, and 37 is going to have 1, 6 and 8. So it's 1, 6 and 8. And on 38 it's 2, 6 and 7. And the OSPF configuration should be done. Let's see the Actually, let's start with the configuration. It's applied. And it is on all these nodes. And let's just see the neighbors. On 3, we have 4 neighbors. On 2, it should be the same. Then 2 and 2 and 2 and 2. And on 38, 3 neighbors. 38, 3 neighbors. And this is how I would also check it in the lab exam. To be honest, you don't have time to see, okay, what neighbors I have enabled, because what other neighbors I could have on router 38. It's just 3 neighbors. There's just 3 interfaces that I have directly connected, and I can't have the wrong neighbor ID. And we're done with the OSPF part. As usual, this is the most boring one. In the next video, I'm going to continue with the MPLS part, where I'm enabling both segment routing and LDP.